Now we'll go ahead and start assembling the head of the robot. This part here. We'll start with the bottom of the head, mounting the two servos in the two holes for them. For this, we'll need 4 M2x8 bolts and corresponding 4 nuts for them. Please note that in this early version of the manual, there is a small typo, and this is 4 M2 screw nuts, not M3 screw nuts. The nuts and the bolts are in back labeled number 2, at least in my version of the set. I will go ahead and take them out. Since there are some more still in the back, I will just go ahead and take out 4 bolts and 4 nuts, and I'll return the rest into the back and leave it aside. Next, I will find this bottom side of the head. It's a base plate. This one. Close the back. Now I will go ahead and peel the protective cover, as we did with the rest of the plastic parts. Peel the second side. Nice and shiny. And now I can go ahead and take out the two servos. Leave the remaining servo parts for later. And see where the servos go and how to mount them. Switch to page 16. Orient with the round hole the same as shown on the picture, and mount the servos with the cables pointing in the same orientation as the round hole. You can see this side as well. So the axle is supposed to go on the same side where the round hole is. If you look carefully, the axle should go pretty much in the center of the base plate. If we mount the servo like this, obviously the axle is way too much on this side. So this is the proper mounting. The instruction shows that the bolts will go from the side opposite to the servo through the base plate, then the servo, and the nut will be placed on the side of the servo. Like this. For now, I will loosely tighten it so I can adjust the servo. Repeat the same procedure on this side. Before I tighten everything, I'll just loosely tighten the bolts. Make sure everything is properly oriented. Repeat the same procedure with the second servo. Bolt from this side, not from the opposite. the same thing with this bolt and corresponding nut. If necessary, use the tweezers to hold the nut in place while tightening. Go ahead and tighten everything in place. And here is how everything should look like once when it is assembled. Very similar to what you see on the picture. Now it is time to mount the legs on the bottom side of the head of the robot. We will also use the two small self-tightening screws from the remaining two servo backs. It is shown on this picture here. There are two M2x5 self-tapping screws. We'll take one of the legs and for simplicity we can fold the servo and place the leg with the servo seat on the axle of the servo on the bottom of the head. Again, similar to the previous servo, do not tighten the screw once when you put it, since we may need to zero the servo, find the zero center position before we tighten the leg, otherwise the robot will be out of alignment. I will show you this step when we start programming the robot. So at that point we will most likely need to loosen the screw, adjust the position of the leg and tighten the screw into new position. I will go ahead and take out the screw. It is this really small screw from the back. Leave the rest of the parts aside. Take out the second screw for the other leg. Take one of the screws and insert it in the opening in the center of the seat right here. Into the axle of the servo. Then use the screwdriver to tighten it in place. Like this. Do not over tighten, since we most likely need to adjust the position of the servo. Repeat the same procedure with the second leg. Make sure this part of the leg is on the outside, like this. Do not place it like this, otherwise the two legs will interfere with each other, the two feet of the legs. Find good angle to access the screw and use the screwdriver to tighten the screw in place. Do not over tight, so we can adjust the servo angle properly at later point. What I just noticed is that the servos have different length of the cables. Unfortunately, I did not notice this on time. So I most likely will have to swap two servos to make sure that the servos with shorter cables are on the top and the servos with longer cables are on the bottom. I'm not going to show you all that, as it's going to take me a while to take everything apart and swap the servos. Just make sure that when you follow the instructions, leave the servos with shorter cables to mount them on the head. This is what happens when you assemble a brand new robot that you're not familiar with for the first time. I have not even seen the robot assembled before I started doing this tutorial. So obviously I made a small mistake, not realizing the different length of cables for the servos. The reason we will mount the servos with the longer cables on the bottom is that the cables should be able to reach the control board within the head. Other than that, we are progressing quite well, and this step are now completed. Now I'll go ahead and fix my mistake with the length of the cables, then we'll continue with the next step of mounting the control board.